Hey, good morning, friends. Mark Holmes here, and of course, Michael Anthony's knocked out. But as always, thank you guys for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Blue Sports Report. Without you guys, man, this doesn't work. Man, I'm as excited as I can be. You know, we've got the team headed to Oxnard. We'll find out if Zeke Elliott is or is not going to hold out. You know, there's been a whole lot of speculation from Mike Ferrello. And Mike Ferrello is one of those people that is, you know, right on or completely off. But then again, most of those guys are. And we'll have to wait and see. We'll know in a few hours. I'm on the road today, about halfway to where I need to go. Go and put some replace some gutters, I should say. Not repair, replace. Interesting story that was out about Jason Witten. You know, we know Jason Witten's 37 years old, coming back for his 16th training camp. His first one being in the Alamo Dome, 2003. And in this article, they talk about him dreaming about winning the Super Bowl in Miami. And let's be honest, you know, his chances are few and far between at this point. And dreaming about holding up that Lombardi Trophy. And this is where you look at this and say, one of the benefits of bringing back, well, there's several benefits of bringing back, and I know some people are like, he's old, he's slow, but you know, this is one of those situations when you look at a Jason Witten and a Sean Lee, guys that have given everything to the team, that, you know, the rest of these guys, these young guys, can look up, they get mentored by them, because I think part of the reason why we are seeing Leighton Vander Esch and Jalen Smith playing as well as they do is because Sean Lee literally is a field general out there. He has taught those guys so much, and I'm hoping that that's going to be the effect of Jason Witten, that guys will look up to him and inspire to be like him. You know, it's funny because they always say, is it how many degrees of separation you are from people? And it's amazing because my old boss, I used to work in restaurants, Sam's Deli's, and that's great because it taught me a lot of my cooking as well as doing catering and stuff. So, you know, you see me out there as a one-man show cooking and serving 150 people last year. Well, that's because that's what I used to do at Sam's Deli. We would cater weddings and company picnics and barbecues and stuff like that. So it's kind of been instilled in me. Sam ended up, hadn't talked to him in years, and he ended up sending me a Facebook message, and he said, you know, I know you are a huge Cowboy fan, and I have something I want to share with you. And I was like, okay, what you got? And he sent me this picture, the one that is actually our cover photo here. He said, you know, Jason Witten grew up in Vienna. And I was like, yeah, because, you know, that's where I grew up. I said, yeah, I heard that, you know, but I didn't really know it was true or not. But they kept saying that Jason went until he was 11 years old, grew up, you know, basically a mile from where I grew up. And he said, you know, I said, yeah. He said, well, he was on our ankle biters team. And he said, here's the picture of him and circled with Jason Witten. And I said, I'll be damned. And so I wonder if, as a little kid playing Little League football, if he ever dreamed of playing in the NFL, not only playing in the NFL, playing for the Dallas Cowboys, and playing for as long as he has, and knowing that he's going to be a Hall of Famer. You know, we all as kids have dreams of being like a fighter pilot, or, you know, a fireman and things like that, or, you know, a football player. But for him to actually be able to do that and live that's just incredible. And that's where you look at a season like this, and that's where these young guys who know what this guy has done. I mean, it's like playing with the Hall of Fame. Not like, it is playing with the Hall of Fame. And you want to give that extra bit to help be a part of his history. I don't know if that makes any sense or not, but basically, he's a motivational factor. Now, make no mistake about it, it's not just about the motivation, it's not just about the coaching ability. Jason Witten, a lot of people say, well, he's slow. Well, Jason Witten has never been a speedster. But Jason Witten is one of those guys that always runs those precise routes. And that is one of those things that's key. Because that quarterback's going to know where you're supposed to be, where I don't have to look and follow you. I can look off and know, boom, that's where you're going to be, and that's where that ball's going to go. And make no mistake about it, one of the downfalls or shortcomings of this team last year was red zone. And the problem with red zone is you can move the ball because you've got lots of space when you're, you know, on a 20 or 30 or 50-yard line. But when you get down into that red zone, the field is small. It is tight, and there's not a lot of room to operate. And it's crowded down there. You've got all the cornerbacks, the safeties, the linebackers in there. So that's where you need that guy, that wily veteran, who can find that soft spot in the zone and get open, that has those short hands. And if we can just do a little bit better in the red zone, you know, if we had last year, a lot of those games that we lost early in the season, we would have had the opportunity to win because we're settling for field goals. Touchdowns are huge, and you've got to convert. If we can do that, and if Jason Witten can be that guy, as well as, you know, that blocker as well, man, that's huge. And you want to send that guy off with that Super Bowl ring. You know, it really, it amazes me that so many things are right there in front of you, or around you, or happening around you that you have no clue as to, you know? But I'm happy today. This weekend, we'll be talking about practice. Are you guys excited as can be? I am. And I'm going to get my work done down here. I'm going to get my butt back and keep on working on the man cave, because I want that bad boy ready for the season. In fact, I've got to stop by Michael's. I got to get some more picture frames for the Joe Boo jerseys. We're taking the furniture from upstairs, the living room, and putting it down in the man cave. So we got extra seating and better seats and stuff to go down in there. I got some rewiring